Hey, what's up, everybody? This is What's to Talk About with Dre James, episode special. Man, okay, look, I played Watch Dogs Legion. I'm a big fan of the whole Watch Dogs franchise, from the first one to the second one. I like the second one even more because the protagonist is a black guy, Marcus. What's his name? Marcus. Fuck it. I don't care. His name is Marcus. And, you know, and then we have the new installment into the franchise, Watch Dogs Legion. Excuse me. I tongue-tied myself. Now, I was pretty excited that Watch Dogs had a sequel, you know. Saw the trailer. I was infatuated of how the gameplay, how the environments looked. I was like, oh, wow, we are across the pond over to England. And, you know, we was going to get like a fucking single protagonist, but it turned out, no, it's like a group of people you can recruit on the streets, and you can hack stuff with the multi-camera system. You know, you can hack cameras, you can like commandeer vehicles with your phone, you can do anything, you know what I'm saying? But it, you know, at the same time, it felt it felt kind of limited, like certain things from the first two that I really wanted in the third installment, Legion. So, like you know how you walk around the streets, you know, either you're Aiden Pierce or you're Marcus, and then you take off your you pull off your phone. And then you can profile people and you eject their money and then you go to the ATM. Well, in the first game, it was like, you know, it had two steps. You can swipe their money, then get stored on your phone. Then you can walk to an ATM and then you can like pair your phone to the ATM. It fucking glitched all pure hell. And then you can have their money in your account or in your pocket or whatever. This one is like, you don't get none of that shit. Your phone is strictly to recruit people to your calls. That is it. Or, you know, there is some a little snippet of backstory of the people that you're trying to recruit, but that is mainly it. I wish you can profile people a little bit more, like, you know, I mean, you can send like text, like weird text to people, and they freak the fuck out, and they be like, "Oh shit! Oh, what the hell?" Or they have a, "Oh, that's cute," or whatever, you know. But I wish at that point it was like a little bit more of what I'm used to from the second game. Well, first two games. So story. Story is like you're in England and you were with this James Bond character or whatever, and you try to navigate stealthily into Parliament, trying to disengage these bombs because a certain sect is trying to sabotage the buildings and shit and what have you. All right. So you navigating into Parliament, and you try and do your job, but at the same time, the real bad guys show up and they blow up like the three other buildings and stuff, and you naturally are you are confronted by the main antagonist of the game, or which they call themselves Zero Day. All right, now when I heard that name, I was like, Zero Day, wait, hold on. Zero Marcus from the second game is reprising his role as an antagonist because, you know, his name was Zero, but not at the end, which I get to that later. It's going to be a spoiler full investments video or audio, depends on where you at. Anyway, so it takes you along the lines of building up your staff of hackers into DedSec, and it's like it's split up into, I think it's like five antagonists. I think it's there's a double agent, there's the Brainiac who is obsessed with taking the mental psyche out of a living person into a machine. Then you have the Albion CEO who has martial law over the England after the first, well, not the first act, but the prologue of the game. Then you have the mob boss, the female mob boss, Bloody Mary. Then you have the real antagonist, Zero Day. All right, so you navigating throughout the city, recruiting people, you know, it's kind of, you know, it's very easy to navigate. I didn't have a problem navigating to recruit other people for the cause of Dead Set. But, yeah, it's like I split everything off and I was playing the game. Okay, look, I'm going to do... I mean, kind of forces you one by one of each boss, but it wasn't really, this game wasn't really as tedious as I not hoped for, but I'm glad it wasn't tedious. It was kind of repetitive at times because depending on the mission that you are doing, it's like pretty much it's the same shit. Go to a building, hack all the cameras, find out where shit is, and then you like either stealthily take down people. And or you can go guns a-blazing, and then you can kill off the people in the building. Thus, after you do that, you go to the goal and you complete the mission. All right. And each time you do that for each person, it is repetitive. Mechanics of the game. Wow. Driving is still the shits. The driving of the game is holy fuck. It's still loosey goosey. I think you have to go and fucking options and tweak up your sensitivity because the drive. I mean, you steer with the left analog stick and you kind of control it. While you're steering in your vehicle, the camera moves too. It's not like Grand Theft Auto where, like, okay, the left stick is driving and the right stick is the camera that and it cleanly goes with the car. The right analog stick in this game is like a free camera, so it don't syncs with the vehicle that you're driving. And now if you one of them motherfuckers that think I'm wrong, then you are stupid. You are fucking stupid. That fucking free camera that you control the right analog stick while you driving is not syncing up with the car. So it's like it took me a while to get used to it. You know, learning system. Okay, the accelerator is right trigger. The brake is left trigger. Then you have the left thumbstick to steer the car, and the camera moves with it at the same time. Bikes are still good in this game. Bikes is very, what's the word I'm looking for? Bikes are very easy to drive, for lack of a better word. Just like the previous two. You're going to fall in love with the motorcycles, right? But, you know, you drive hard, and then you crash into another vehicle, and then you fly out the seat to the ground. I mean, that can't happen in real life, really. And I beat the game. I was so accomplished, you know, they do have those little hacking Swiss trees type things where you turn the dial and you move the flow of information when it turned from red to blue. Some of it was a noodle scratcher, like, how the hell am I going to do this? And then you figure it out, like, oh, okay, I got it. You know, but the... There are some trickier puzzles where you gotta pay attention. Like, I remember the last level that I played. It was like playing the game of Simon. I hated Simon. Well, why'd they do that to me? I don't know. I had to go on YouTube. They didn't explain too much, but I actually, like, there were some screens where the Simon thing comes up, and then I had to write a diagram. I had to get some scrap paper, write a diagram, and then look at the response I get. The game was trying to mimic it. And then I wrote down the responses on my pad. Then once it was my turn, and all I had to do was look at the number that I wrote down in that synchronous order. And then that's how I beat it. You know, because, you know, well, yeah, it comes a time where you had to go to the Zero Day hideout. And that's when you had to do that little Simon repetitive repeat thing, you know. But anyway, the characters of the game didn't really excite me. I mean, there are some characters that you will enjoy playing with, but you didn't feel no draw to them. You know what I'm saying? Like, you didn't really care for the individuals that you're controlling. The only thing you cared about was like, damn, they got good perks to complete missions. You know, there's some people that you would have to control that work best for the mission, But you really know that, really, to fully understand the missing. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you could go to the missing zone and then, like, okay, if you hack your cameras and stuff, you see what you can and cannot do, then you can, like, hit options on the PS4, because if you are playing, I played it on PlayStation. You hit the options button, and then you'd be like, change the operative that best fits for the job. So, it is what it is with that one. But I didn't really care about the characters that much. The only person that I cared about the people in this game is this, like, the spy person, the lady with the silenced pistol. That was my go-to lady right there, because she had the silenced pistol, you know. With the perk tree and the options, with certain things that you can have to apply some even more perks to your weapons, you can silence that stun gun that everybody has, but it still make noise. It sounds like it make noise, and other people get drawn in by that noise, so that didn't really fix the problem. Glitches. You were run up with some glitches. Me, my personal experience playing the game, it was only, like, you know, funny glitches. Like, for example, I had to, I was riding on the bike, right? And I stopped, and after I stopped, I continued to move, and then all of a sudden, the bike flipped into, like, a backflip, and then landed on two wheels. You know what I'm saying? But when I was playing the last mission, I don't know what I did. Like, I think I was trying to take down somebody, but I fucked up, and then all of a sudden, the person I was controlling was, like, moving in the circle, and I couldn't do anything. And then it went to a blue screen, and then I got logged out, and then I logged back in, and I was at the same spot that I was at before. I could fully move my character and everything. So it is what it is with that one. But, you know, this game is fun. If you're a fan of the Rostov series, I mean, this game is fun, besides the fucking glitches. Because let me tell you something, the glitches I saw was funny as fuck. I love funny glitches, but some of the people that I know, they had some glitches that was game-breaking, you know? It blue-screened their PS4s a couple times, and then they got pissed off and quit. You know, it will happen, but, you know, I was just waiting for this game to be like probably $20, and then you get it if you haven't, you know. But anyway, that's my rating right there. You know, it's a good game to wait for the game to get cheap. That's how you do it. So anyway, thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. I don't know what the fuck I did with my mouth. I'm talking bullshit, but I said whatever. Anyway, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And I will be putting this on YouTube and on my podcast platforms. Share, rate, and review. I'm on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and also Spotify and iCloud Media and Anchor. Yeah. Like, comment, subscribe. Social media links will be down in the description box below. And by all means, be nice to one another and eat healthy. Anyway, peace out.